Hey there, today I'd like to show you how to transition from polygonic items to asset packs. As you may have noticed, we changed the extension of the source files from .zip, which is a standard Blender Addon extension, to .pack, which stands for asset pack file. The pack file cannot be installed like a normal Blender Addon, because it's just an archive file with the assets, and there is no actual code inside it. The code part has been moved to another Addon that we develop, which is called engon. Engon is a free open source addon that you can get, and it will allow you to register asset packs inside it and unlock all the code features such as bottleneck animations or traffic flow path. It also has its own asset browser with advanced filtering, auto updater and other cool stuff. So you can use asset packs either with engon, which is what we recommend, or you can use them just as an asset pack file that you can load inside the Blender asset browser. And I will actually show you both ways how to do it. So let's start with the first way with engon. So the first thing I need to do is go to Edit, Preferences, Addons, and I can either type all the individual addon names that I want to update, or I can just type polygonic and it will list all the polygonic addons. And I need to remove all of them in order to update asset packs. Okay, now that we've removed all the addons, we need to restart Blender. Alright, now with Blender restarted, we can see we've got some missing file paths and the asset links are broken, so we'll fix that soon. Go back to Edit, Preferences, and install the engon, which is a standard addon with .zip extension. And once we enable the addon, we go to the Install Asset Pack section, and we need to locate the .pack files and install them. Here I can change the directory for the installation. I will just leave it at default for now and click OK. Okay, we see that the installation was successful. We can now do the same for the remaining asset packs. So now that we are done, we see that all the asset packs are successfully installed into engon. And I can close the preferences and we can see under the engon, we've got the subpanels for the individual asset packs, and here are the specific code features for each asset pack. I can now go to engon and to the blend maintenance section, and we will now fix the broken file paths by using the find missing files and the migrate assets button. Right now with the path fixed, we can go to the engon asset browser and we can see that we've got the asset packs registered, we've got all the previews, we've got all the filtering options, and we can just spawn new assets with a click of a button. We can also go to the asset browser and here we can see we've got the asset packs registered inside the asset browser as well, so we can spawn them from here. Okay, let's now look how to use the asset packs without the addon. As you can see that no addon is installed this time. And all I need to do is locate the .pack file. And if I right click it, show more options, 7-zip, and I can extract the archive file. And I can just move it wherever I want. I will keep it at this location at this time. And if I go inside, I can see that there is the .cats.txt, which is the Blender catalog definition. So all we need to do is go to Edit, Preferences, File Paths, Asset Libraries, and we navigate to the location where we've seen the .cats.txt file and click Add Asset Library. Right, now we can go to the Asset Browser window. And we can see that Aquatic Fool has been added to the asset libraries. We can now do the same for the remaining asset packs. Okay, now that we've gone through all the asset packs, we can see that all of them are registered inside asset browser and ready to be spawned. Thank you for watching and see you next time.